Hi guys, it's MTG here, and today I'm going to talk about some more hidden features that could help you out when using your Galaxy S8 and Galaxy S8 Plus. The first feature involves Bixby, or Samsung's voice assistant that people rarely use. When the phone was first announced, people were disappointed with the fact that Samsung put a physical button on the side of the S8 that was mapped to a voice assistant that wasn't even ready yet. Today, Bixby Voice is available, but also available are ways to remap the button to whatever command you'd like through apps like Bixby. Simply download Bixby from the Google Play Store. Once the app is installed, click the toggle in the top right corner and make sure the permissions are turned on. Once this is done, you'll be able to remap the Bixby button to any app, the flashlight, or other phone commands. It's as simple as selecting the command you'd like to map the button to and closing the app. Now, whenever you click the button, the command will execute. In this case, I have mapped it to the YouTube app. Initially, the launch times will be fairly slow, but if you keep using the button or if the app is already open, the button will launch faster. The next couple of hidden features involve the S8's camera. In case you didn't know, you can quick launch the camera even when the phone is locked by double-clicking the power button. If this isn't working for you, you can turn it on by going to Settings, Advanced Features, then toggle on Quick Launch Camera. Once you're in the camera app, there are a couple more useful hidden features. Sometimes, when you're taking a picture, especially one-handed, the shutter button can be awkward to reach. Samsung combated this problem by allowing you to put a floating shutter button on the screen that you'll be able to put right where your thumb naturally sits. To turn this on, simply click the Settings icon in the top right corner, scroll down, and toggle on Floating Camera button. Another cool feature that is built into the camera app is the ability to zoom using the main shutter button. Simply hold down the shutter button and push right to zoom in and back left to zoom out. This will allow you to stay more stable when attempting to zoom by not forcing you to pinch and zoom. On the S8, and through software updates on other devices, Samsung has really done a great job of improving on their multitasking ability of the devices. Now it's easier than ever to split the screen in just about every way you would want. To multitask, there isn't anything you have to turn on in settings. Simply click the menu button. You'll notice that there are these icons on the app strip. The first icon lets you set how much and what part of the app you'd like to pin to the top. Once you resize and click done, you'll be able to select the app you'd want to put on the bottom. To exit out, just click the home button as always. The second button automatically puts the app on the top half of the screen and lets you choose an app to place on the bottom. To see additional options, press in the side you'd like to alter, then press the bar that separates the two apps. From this menu, you'll see the first icon again that pins a portion of the app to the top. The second icon switches the positions of the two apps that are open. Lastly, the third option allows you to make a pop-up window of the app and will allow you to browse your phone as usual with the app staying where it is. I'd also like to note that all these features work both in portrait and landscape. Samsung has always put back, home, and menu buttons on their smartphones. But since the S8 has software buttons, they give you additional flexibility on what you can do with them. You can customize the navigation bar by going to Settings, Display, Navigation Bar. From this menu, you'll be able to turn on the navigation bar's ability to hide. When this is on, you'll be able to double tap the little dot to hide the bar, swipe up to show it, and double tap the little dot to lock the bar again. You'll also be able to change the background color of the navigation bar to very light shades of various colors. On previous Samsung phones, the back button is permanently placed to the right of the home button. But on the S8, you'll be able to change the position of the back button to the more logical placement on the left side of the home button. The last feature I want to talk about today involves the S8's ability to search through the phone. When you open the app tray, the search bar at the top does not simply allow you to search for apps. It acts more like how Spotlight search on Mac works. You'll be able to search for apps on your phone as you thought, but the S8 will also search for the search terms in your emails, messages, files, and in Galaxy apps. If you click the filter button, you'll be able to find different search parameters that you could filter the results from. You'll be able to search just conversations, documents, music, and more. You can also limit the time frame for it to search through. If you like that video, please give this video a thumbs up. I'm continually working on a lot of new content right now, so please click the logo down below to subscribe, and make sure the notification bell is clicked so that you stay up to date on my latest videos. If you like a behind-the-scenes look at what I'm up to, check the description for a link to my Twitter account. And again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.